Hello everyone, we are going to see some technical term, physical term in periodic motion. See, we have taken an example of a simple pendulum which does oscillatory motion to and fro motion from its mean position here, O to A, A to O, O to B and B to O for one revolution, and again it's repeat the path, right? Here some of the terms which we are going to explain here. Now see the first term, that is the time period. Time period is denoted by capital T, and it is defined as the least time interval after which the periodic motion repeats its path. Seen the example of a simple pendulum, when it's repeat the path, one oscillation, this is time taken to reach from to complete one oscillation, this is also called, that is time taken to complete one revolution. One complete path, right? Here this is from O to A, then A to B, then again B to A is the time. See, the time can be, time period can be changed by changing the value of applied force due to this pendulum oscillate. Here are since this motion is a simple harmonic motion, if it is considered under a constant amplitude and frequency, in that two sine wave are here given, x and y. X is represented by a red, where a red color, and y wave is here black in color and with dotted line. This is two sine wave. So if more than one sine wave is in the displacement time graph, then it is called sinusoidal wave. Sinusoidal wave is represented here as a sinusoidal wave, which is represented here this in the wave. Here in this sinusoidal wave, if we take this X wave, see this is X wave, which has a time period C, one oscillation. It is. This is one complete wave. So time period is denoted here and represented by T1. For second wave is this C. The time period is only T2. For Y wave, the time period is T2. And here in the diagram, T2 is just half of the first time period in this sinusoidal wave. Seen it is two sinusoidal wave. So time, what is a time period? Time taken to complete one cycle or one revolution, oblique cycle. Its unit is second, right? Now we are going to see the second term. Here in it, periodic motion, the second term is frequency. This frequency is generally denoted by sine mu or sometime n also. Right? See, mathematically it is defined as number of cycle per second, number of revolution per second. See, in the case of simple pendulum here, when it is made to oscillate, during the oscillatory motion, see how many complete oscillation made by the simple pendulum in 1 second. That is called its frequency, right? So number of cycle per second is called, per second, its unit is per second. And it is also called hertz. It is measured in unit hertz. Right? See, this frequency may be integer or not. Sometimes in 1 second may be complete number of oscillation, or may be in fractional also. So n or nu may be integer, may not be. So see very carefully. Now we are going to see the another physical quantity here. This is called angular frequency. Angular frequency is related by omega. See very carefully here in time displacement graph. Is this in time displacement graph, if we say displacement and angular displacement theta, if we represent here. So see, it is in term of theta for sinusoidal wave which has a time period t1. So this angle is becomes 2 pi. See, it is one complete oscillation, 0 to extreme, extreme to 0, 0 to extreme in another direction, come back. This is called 2 pi in angular displacement. And in time period it is called t. This time is a t1. For second sinusoidal wave, see here, the time period is a t2 and it is angle is a 2 pi. Right? Angular frequency, omega is obtained by, it is type of frequency after multiplying by angular displacement, 2 pi. Omega is 2 pi and it is represented in unit radian per second. After watching this angular frequency, we are going to see another physical quantity that is called displacement. What is a displacement? See very carefully here in the diagram to understand it. Suppose at particular time t, the position of bob is here. Then displacement gives the distance between these two positions and it is represented in term of y. So displacement is the position of a moving body at any instant t from mean position. So see, it is displacement is denoted by y and it is position of periodic moving body. Which type of moving body? Periodic motion body at given instant t from mean position. Right? So it is represented by y. Right? And its unit is in MK system meter, or in CGS system centimeter. Now one more is here. Amplitude is denoted by small a or capital A. We may represent, right? and it is a maximum displacement from mean position. Maximum displacement from mean position. See in the diagram here. Maximum position or extreme position is here in the diagram. So this distance, see here, from mean position to the position of extreme here, it is called amplitude. Maximum position. Here in sinusoidal wave, see, it is amplitude of first sine wave and this is amplitude of second sine. A1 and A2. So, for X sine wave, the amplitude is A1. For second sinus wave is A2 here in the diagram. So, here in this topic, we have studied about amplitude, displacement, angular frequency, frequency, and the time period of a sinusoidal waves, right? So this is for the topic only. The rest topic, that is the phase and phase difference, we will see in a fresh topic. So this is for today only. Thank you and have a nice day to all.